It's guest time on American Bandstand, and ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to introduce a man who has broken records all over the world. Here's Little Richard. For a half second, because this man has got a lot to talk about. Now, you have traveled all over the world. You have seen so many of the artists of the... I want to ask you about other people before we get to you. You've worked with the Beatles, have you not?
I've just finished a tour with the Beatles. In fact, I toured with the Beatles right before they made their first hit, and I was the star of the show. You wouldn't believe it.
No, I could believe it, but you mean they weren't heard of at that point?
They have never made a record at the time, and I accepted them on my show through Germany. I was with them for 15 days. In fact, I made this picture here
let me see
the Beatles, and that was right before that they got their start.
And look at Ringo here. He's changed a good deal since then.
Yes, he's a wonderful person.
Let me turn from the Beatles to other English artists. They're all doing your material. They're doing Chuck Berry's material. Of course, they're doing their own. Who's the biggest star in England right now?
The Rolling Stones.
Really?
Yeah.
Have they taken over from the Beatles?
Well, I just left England about 4 weeks ago. I did a tour over in England and Germany and all. And the Rolling Stones, they're number one in England at the present time.
Now, people here are beginning to talk about a group called the Animals. What are they?
I've just finished a tour with the Animals. And
that sounds kind of funny.
I've just left them. I was with Chuck Berry and the Animals just about 4 weeks ago in England. And the Animals are really, to me, they are the best group I've ever heard.
Now, here's the thing that I was getting at. You and Chuck have kind of taken England by storm. How do you feel about other people borrowing your material?
Well, Dick, I must be truthful. I'm very grateful to know that my material is the type of material that the entertainers today would like to use.
Well, that's good. Now, let's turn to you specifically in this country. You're working on the Hollywood Palace with Steve Allen. You're going out on tour. You're going to go up to San Francisco?
Yes. My first date with my tour will be September the 11th. I'm going to appear at Hollywood Bowl along with the Beach Boys.
Well, that'll be a gas. And this is in September?
September the 11th.
And then you go up to the Cow Palace.
Cow Palace in Frisco. Then I go to Carnegie Hall for Mary Kay.
Oh, it's going to be a gas. Yeah. I got to catch you along the way. Will you spend a few minutes at our autograph table?
I'd be very, very glad to.
Nice to have you with us.
Thanks,
Richard. Little Richard, ladies and gentlemen. We'll join you at the autograph table. We'll be back in just a moment.
That's right, boy. It seems like old times having Little Richard on the show. And speaking of old times, just a reminder that next week, American Bandstand celebrates its 7th anniversary. Boy, it doesn't seem we've been around that long. Seems like just yesterday. And you'll be seeing some of the old faces of some of the regulars from back in the Philadelphia days. 8 years. We go into our 8th year next week on American Bandstand. Right now, to help keep your breath fresh and your teeth clean, here's Dick with a message about Dentene.